Hello everyone, welcome to today's video. I am filming a quick intro because this is kind of like a pre-intro. Wow, this is great. I'm really excited to kind of take you guys on a day with me where I'm going to be doing some housekeeping things, but I have two things in mind that I want to share with you that are really, really cool. And I just figured I would do kind of like a vlog style video of me kind of going through my day and like show you the two products I wanted to show you. Anyway, before that though, I'm gonna procrastinate a little bit. I'm gonna procrastinate cleaning the house and I'm gonna get some lunch because actually it's lunchtime. So perfect excuse to kind of delay cleaning a little bit. But I have been kind of like really into doing, I've been doing like a health kick basically. I'm doing a more Mediterranean style diet, so I figured I'm gonna show you guys what I eat. That's kind of the reason I started this video now, because I'm gonna show you guys hopefully what I'm having for lunch. Hopefully it's gonna turn out to look pretty cute. Sometimes I'm not really good at like actually presenting food in like a good way, so we'll see. But anyway, so come along with me for the day and we'll hang out and do kind of boring stuff but with really cool tools, products, stuff like that. Also, just a word of warning, my face is really oily, it's super humid, my hair is just like doing whatever, so today's not gonna be a cute kind of day. I do have a lot of makeup on, I just filmed a video, that's why I have a lot of makeup on. I don't normally clean the house with like a full face of makeup on, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna kind of turn into something, I'm not sure what, by the end of the day, so just kind of be warned, I'm not gonna look like so cute today. So just okay, it took forever and a day to get my lunch prepared. Like it was all prepared, I just had to like put it together, but somehow it always takes me forever and I'm not even in focus. But anyway, I'm gonna grab my apron before we have lunch because this is gonna be this lunch is gonna need an apron, I have a feeling. Let me just put that on really quickly because I actually want to show you guys the apron because it's fantastic. All right, now it's officially lunchtime. I'm putting on an apron, yes, because my lunch is gonna be, it's gonna need an apron, I have a feeling. But I just wanted to show you this apron because it's amazing. I love this thing. It's just like I don't know why I'm obsessing over an apron, but it's so good. It is by William Sonoma. And I don't know why, but this is like the best apron ever. So if you're looking for an apron that you can get for like the whole family with different sizes, I think they have like, I think it's kid size and adult size. They come in like different colors and it's just the best apron. Like, I don't know why it is, but it's fantastic. It's nice and the material is like nice and thick, but it's also easy to clean. Like that's a big thing with this apron. It's so easy to clean. As far as lunchtime, this is a weird lunch that Yana's having. She's having a salmon salad, which I don't know if that's a thing, but it is for me, with like lots of vegetables and beans, cantaloupe beans, some underneath there. There's a little bit of cheese, like sheep cheese, some olives, and then some hemp hearts and some olive oil. I don't know, I just try to pile as much stuff that I think is good for me and just kind of eat all of that, and it usually tastes pretty good. I do have some Italian salad dressing on the salad, and then my favorite thing, tea, and it is Earl Grey by Rishi. I love this tea, oh my gosh, it's so good. And if you see little specks in there, it's because the tea ended up kind of overflowing, so the actual tea leaves are in there, but that's okay. And some Saint Pellegrino as well, which I'm probably mispronouncing, but I love that. So we're trying to be healthy as per usual. Who knows what healthy is nowadays, but that is my kind of version for today, what I think might be good for lunch. Although, have to be honest, I'm gonna turn you guys around for a second. So I have to be honest, I had the same lunch, almost like the same lunch yesterday, and it was not enough. Like it looked really healthy and looked really good and it was really good, but I just remember dinner time I was so hungry. I had so much for dinner and like I would rather have more during the day than like have a ton for dinner, but I was just so hungry, and I think it's because like I just needed more, so I try to add more to this lunch and hopefully we'll see how good I was at like adding a ton of stuff. I mean, I don't know, this looks like a lot of food, so hopefully it's enough. I don't know, we'll see. Anyway,
on a scale of like 1 to 10, how good am I feeling at this log thing? I'm not, like, yeah. I'm probably still gonna post it even if it sucks, but we'll see.
All right, so I would give this lunch a solid like 9 out of 10. It was a good lunch, filling, weird but good is the final verdict on that one. I'm not gonna show you what's left because it's like, you know, gross. Okay, so you know what I'm gonna do now? I was thinking like, okay, what can I do instead of cleaning? Let's find something to do like right now that's way more important than like cleaning, which honestly cleaning would probably take me like half an hour, an hour. But like, I just really don't want to do it. But I'm going to show you guys something that I recently picked up at the store. I was eyeing it for a while and I saw it and I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna get it. It was kind of an impulse buy, but kind of like, I also like wanted it, researched it, planned it out. And then I finally decided to get it. So is that an impulse buy? I don't know. But let me just go ahead and like set up a camera and I'll show you what I'm talking about really quickly. Don't judge me, it's a little dorky, but I'm like so into it. So
today's one of those days when I've committed to a lip liner, and once you commit to a lip liner, especially one that you overline your lips with, you kind of can't uncommit. So I just went back and put it back on because it looked really weird, like because I didn't have like any foundation around my lips and I just had this like faded lip liner line that just like, nope, had to put it back on. So I'm probably gonna look really extra. But I have committed, so what are you gonna do? I do like this Tower 28 Beauty lip balm stick, whatever it's called, tinted lip balm. But I don't know, like, I don't know if it's my lips because my lips are kind of small, but it's not very easy to apply it like in the precise way because it's just like this round shape, you know what I mean? Like, so I don't know, I love it, I love the formula of it, I just don't know if I like the shape. Very end of this hand cream, but I am squeezing every little bit out of it because I'm getting my money's worth out of that hand cream. You better believe I'm gonna squeeze every last bit. Although sometimes I have to be honest, like there's times when I have just like tried to squeeze like the very last bit of like toothpaste and my hands would hurt. I would like be trying to squeeze out so much. And I thought to myself, you know, it's probably not worth like to just put yourself through it. And like, it's probably not that great for my thumbs and whatnot to like press so hard into the toothpaste. So I don't know, it's probably like a balance where you do want to get the most out of it, but just like maybe don't hurt yourself doing it, right? Okay, yay, let's talk about something I'm super excited about. Hopefully you will be as well. I'm gonna be talking about some soap. But like bear with me for a second because it's not just like a regular soap. So first of all, it's made in France and it's a traditional French milled recipe that dates back to 1828. So like this is just, it's like a piece of history. It's a French soap made in France, which to me always just like sounds really fancy and just like interesting to try. So it's a traditional French milled recipe. The company is called A La Maison de Provence. Probably not sure if I'm saying that right. Probably not. I took French in high school. That's always something I say at the end of anything I say in French because I know it sounds bad, but I'm like, I took it, I tried. Ooh. Anyway, so that's the brand. And I gotta read you the back really quickly because it's just, it sounds really interesting. Like, I promise this like soap has like a bit of history steeped into it, or the soap is steeped in history. I don't know what the expression is, but you know what I'm trying to say. Okay, so our traditional recipe dates back to 1828 in France when Marseille soap masters developed the famous French milled process, a slow cooking and purifying process which transforms vegetable oils into glycerin-rich, smooth and lathering soaps, softer to the skin than other liquid soaps. So I don't know, I was just so excited to give this a try just because like it sounds like a little bit of history. It sounds like you get to try something that like to me is just very unusual and different. And I also love the ingredients in here. I'm gonna read them to you very quickly. It's like a short list, but it's really, really like, it's really nice to know what's in here. So there's filtered water, coconut oil, olive oil, a vegetable, glycerin, argan oil, vitamin E, aloe leaf extract, and to finish it off, there's a fragrance blend with plant extracts and or essential oils. So it's a very short list, but it's filled with like really hydrating ingredients like coconut oil, olive oil, glycerin, and argan oil. And then obviously a couple of other ingredients, but just like an incredible, like, I don't know. I'm like super fascinated by this soap. And I have to say that the formula here is incredible. I'm not a soap expert, obviously. I'm sure there are, but I'm not one of them. But I've tried a couple soaps in my life just because, like, you do, right? And I have to say, I feel like this is one of like very few soaps, maybe the only soap that's just like, it's so creamy. And it's not like creamy where a soap's trying to be creamy, but it's like not that creamy. You know those soaps like where they're like trying to be, but they're not, like, I don't know if that makes any sense, but I've tried those and they kind of like, they try to be, but they're not. This one is like creamy through and through. Like, I have to somehow show you some kind of like a snippet here of me trying to use it, but it's almost like hard to visualize. You kind of have to try it, but it's just so emollient. Like, oh, it's so good. And I also want to mention the scent here. So I have to say this, I chose this soap because of the color, because to me this like rich amber color feels very traditional for some reason. I have no idea why. Also, lavender aloe sounds traditional, so I just kind of like, I probably bought into marketing, I don't know. And the scent here is quite strong when you're using it, at least for this particular scent. It does come in other scents that I'm definitely eyeing because I'm like really into the soap now. It's kind of like a little bit of a spa experience for me. But so the scent, the particular one here, when you're using it, definitely feels quite strong, and your hands do smell like that for a while afterwards. But when I first used it, I have to say, like, I remember being like, oh gosh, this is gonna be so strong for like the rest of the day now, like, what have I done? But actually, when you're kind of using it in the moment, it's a lot stronger than it is afterwards, and like kind of basically sort of evaporates, and the scent is like not that strong, but it's definitely a scented soap. Normally, I prefer unscented things, but I feel like the soap is kind of like, part of the reason to use it is because it's so luxurious and kind of hydrating and a piece of history, and it's kind of fancy to me that it comes from France, and I believe it's made in France, right? Yeah, product of France, which I think means it's made in France. Anyway, that's, I don't know, to me that's like a really kind of a just a nice special treat to myself, and it makes sense that it has like a pleasant smell to it because, again, it's like a little spa experience for my hands. Okay, so as I'm sitting down, I'm also just gonna quickly mention the two products I love. I've been like really loving using them for cleaning, and they're kind of cool, and I'm just gonna mention them now, although I might kind of like show you guys how obviously they work as I'm cleaning. I just figured since I'm like sitting down and I'm not focused on cleaning, because I know I'm gonna have a hard time doing two things at once. But they are called e-cloth. And basically the cool thing about them is that they can clean surfaces with just water, because they have like the ability to grab onto particles and dirt. And I obviously don't know how to measure like how much they're picking up besides like what I can see, but I will tell you that I have a couple of them, but I'm just gonna mention two because like they're the two I use the most, like two types. So this one here is the type I use for like everywhere. It feels kind of similar to like a regular microfiber cloth. I also love the color. I particularly chose yellow because it's a happy color. But they are very, 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 very grippy. Like, as you're like, you spray water and you drag them across, like, they really feel like they're kind of grabbing onto. It sounds like I'm just making it up. I'm not. Like, it really does feel like super grippy. And I love the fact that you can just use water and not have to worry about like different products. It just makes things a lot simpler. So I've been loving using these. And I also, like, I think this is actually maybe my favorite one of the two, because this is for, I forget if it's for windows or glass, but mirrors or glass, but I particularly use it on like glass surfaces. Like, I have a mirror behind there, and I have a mirror in the bathroom and all of that. So previously I was using like a cheaper kind of a glass cleaner or like glass cleaning cloth, and it wasn't doing as good of a job as this. This does a fantastic job with just water, which is fantastic and like incredible. I want to show you guys two other ones I have. So I have these glass ones that I love as well. These are specifically for glasses. They actually work surprisingly like better than I thought they would, because I've had other like glass polishing cleaning cloths that I thought were pretty good, and they were, but I feel like these are super super great, fantastic. I think I actually have a pair of orange bedtime glasses, like the blue blocking ones, that I could probably clean really quickly. So I'll show you guys what this does, because it's really, really cool. And I also have a tech cleaning glass, which I think is meant for like possibly screens or something like that. This one I'm still testing out. I think it works great, but I don't know if I'm like absolutely obsessed with it like I'm obsessed with like the other ones I mentioned. I mostly honestly use it for like cleaning keyboards and stuff like that, which I don't think you're supposed to, like, this is not the best thing to use it for. I think maybe iPad, like if you have an iPad or something like that. We've got a blender drink going. He warned me though that was gonna happen. So I tend to use this on like my mouse and keyboard, just because that's what I usually need it for. I don't really use it on display so much, only because I'm very careful and like they don't tend to get that dirty. Although I sometimes use it on my phone just to kind of like wipe it down. But yeah, I'm still testing this out, but it's also, in my experience, has been like a pretty good cloth. But I haven't like just personally, I guess I haven't like needed something like this as much as I needed like an everyday cloth, glass / mirror cloth. I've been using it for mirrors, so I'm gonna call it mirror cloth, and sunglasses or glasses cloth. This is also great, especially like, again, just smudges, that kind of stuff. Like, this is a really, really, really good cloth, but I'm just obsessed with these two, obsessed. You know what I'm realizing now as I'm talking? I also will have to show you the water bottle I'm using, or the spray bottle, because it's one of those ones where you like press on it and it just like sprays it afterwards, like for longer than you've pressed on the lever. It's fantastic. It's like this kind of misty, like fancy spray bottle. It's also so, so good. I gotta show that to you as well, which I don't have with me right now because I forgot about it, to be honest with you, but it's so good. I have one in the bathroom, like for bathroom cleaning, like the mirror, and then I also have one that I have like with the just like regular cleaning. So yeah, the weather today, I have to say, like last thing I promise I'll mention before we start like going in cleaning, I'm trying to procrastinate here, is that it's been crazy. It's sunny, then it's like cloudy, then it's sunny, then it's cloudy, then it's sunny, then it's cloudy. Like, I don't know what am I doing here? Am I listening to like happy, upbeat things, or am I like gonna be watching like moody things, or listening to like what kind of mood am I supposed to be in right now? Because even in the morning, I was like outside, and at first, I was not like outside, I was outside. At first, it was just kind of like dark, you know? And then I'm like, okay, it's supposed to rain today. Makes sense. Then all of a sudden it's just like sunny. I'm like, it's been 2 minutes. What's going on? It's very cloudy, then it's sunny. Then it was cloudy, then it started to rain, then it's super sunny, then it was kind of rainy again. Now it's like really bright and sunny. So I'm just like, I don't like this like back and forth. I want to know what kind of mood I'm supposed to be in. And I thought we were going to be in a rainy kind of mood, but I also feel like going for a walk today, so maybe it's for the best. All right, we really got to go clean some stuff. I think because I've procrastinated for so long, we're not going to have a lot of time to clean, so it's okay. It's okay by me.
It's time for some tea. I always love reading the little inspirational messages on here. It says, uncage your heart. Free your heart. Let it be wild. I'm gonna let it be wild today with some organic green tea. Yay! So this is the spray I was talking about earlier. I forgot to show it, but it is so, so, so good. Okay, let me show you how it works. So I press on the trigger, right? Or whatever this thing is called. Like, it is just like this soft mist. Oh, it's so good. I think I just oversprayed, but it's okay. Okay, so then I'm gonna take my e-cloth, and it's just water, right?
You hear that sound? It's because it's like very, very grippy. It has all of these little microfiber bits that just, I guess, grab onto all of like the dirt and debris and whatnot. And yeah, I love it. I wish I had like a really dirty surface to show you, but I don't really have a super dirty surface per se, just because I'm like really, I'm allergic to like cats and dust and whatnot, so I try to keep things somewhat clean. But I have found though that when, like, if I spill coffee or something and like I try to use this, it really works very, very well. Okay, I found a really dirty surface. Look at that. Yay, okay, great, lovely. Let's go ahead and clean that. Although, how am I gonna clean it with one hand? This, by the way, I know it looks really, really gross. It's probably lotion. But nonetheless, let's go ahead and clean that. So I already have water on this. With just water and this thing, like all of the greasy fingerprints are gone. So yeah, that was better. Sorry, I was showing you. I'm like, this is a clean surface already, but like I still technically wipe it down. Like, yeah, that was better. Okay, I'm glad I had something like really, really dirty that I could show you. All right, do you see those fingerprints on there as well? Same thing, it's just basically lotion oil. I'm gonna quickly wipe it down. I'll show you guys in a second what this looks like. This is it. Look at that, all gone. I love this. I mean, I love this, but I also love this and that, just to clarify. All right, so let me see if I can show you guys the dirt on the meat grave, because it's actually hard to see on camera, but like it's pretty easy to see in real life. So okay, let me see. This is gonna be like a creative exercise for us. Like in every other situation, I would like for the camera to hide it. Okay, so there's lint and it's like all over the mirror, right? Like that kind of stuff. I couldn't get it off with like a lint thingy. And then we've got another type of dirt on here. Okay, yeah, perfect. Great shot. That's, yeah, that, I don't know what that is, but. And let me go ahead and show you how easy it is to clean this stuff, because I struggle with cleaning mirrors, always have, always will. And I think this is probably like 95% perfect, and the 5%, it's an odd, but it's like the best thing I've ever tried. And, right, so I'm gonna start with just spraying liberally the whole thing with water. That's what I do. And the sprayer is fantastic. If you have the need for like a very misty kind of sprayer, it's like the best thing ever. I highly recommend it. Okay, so the upper texture here is the like a rougher texture, and then the other side is the smoother texture, and I like the smoother side better. I don't actually know if you're supposed to use one or over the other, but I like the smoother side better. So these are water streaks. You gotta let them dry for a second. And once they dry without like having streaks. I know it looks kind of bad now, but anyway, so I could spend a whole lot of time perfecting everything, but I would say this definitely gets this mirror to like 95% perfect. You don't have smudges, you don't have like a lot of lint. And yeah, I love this. I think it does an amazing job with just water. It's just water. Like there's no cleaning product that you need to get. I think it's fascinating. I know it's probably not worth being so fascinated over something like this, but you know, maybe it is. And in any case, I am so. All right. So I'm going to try to clean these glasses because these are my nighttime fun time orange glasses for blue light blocking. And by the way, isn't this so cute? How cute is this stand? So cute. But let me just show you how dirty they are, and please don't judge me because like they're dirty. Do you see how gross that is? Oh my gosh. Okay, like yuck. I don't clean them as much as I should. I wear them every single night, and this is like basically skincare.
and it's gonna be hard for me to do it with one hand, so I'm just gonna clean it and then I'll come back and I'll show you guys what the after is of these glasses.
Right. Look at that. There's a little scratch on this lens here. You'll see it like right where the reflection is or the like sun is. You see there, that's a scratch. And so great. Yep. This is definitely a great, great, great cloth. I don't know if like, I mean, there's probably other good cloths for like this kind of stuff, but I feel like this has worked really phenomenal. I also kind of like the snatches. I wouldn't get it just because it matched, although knowing me, I might. But yeah. Also, like, ouch, my little pinky was holding the phone. Look at that. Another thing on the chore to do. Towels. Ugh. I actually don't mind folding towels. It's like one of the few things I don't mind doing so much. All right, using the mop. Almost done with this cleaning thing. But I wanted to show you guys this mop because it's such a good mop. I know it's, again, like one of those weird things to talk about, but it's such a good mop. So I want to show you why I think it's fantastic. So look at the spray. It's like, it's such a mist. Oh, you can probably see it better like this. It's very, very misty and it sprays out evenly and far. And the pad is grippy. The head is like really a great size. It pivots, like look. And it's a clean cleaning product. And then like the best part is, let me show you. You can take this thing out. Like look, you press this button, right? And then you can take it out, the cartridge thing. Kind of hard to do with one hand. There's a cap for this and you can store it, hang it however like you want, because it's now it's a lot like lightweight, a lot more lightweight. And and this cleaning solution is clean, so it's not filled with like bad stuff in it, which I don't know what's in it to be honest with you, but it's supposed to be like clean. I forget what like the label is, but it's some kind of like a clean certificate that I think this cleaner has. And then all right, so this is what like the mop head looks like, the pad anyway. Sorry, it's probably a little bit gross and dirty from cleaning this room, this one room thus far. But yeah, I love this thing. It's so, so good. It's like the best mop. And by the way, the handle, I'm just like, sorry, I'm doing it with like my hand. The handle is here. So like you press this and then it sprays the cleaner. It is such a good mop. I'm obsessed with this. All right, I got my shirt on, I got my fanny pack, got my sneakers. We're good to go. Got my book in my ear. The essentials are there. Look at how pretty the sky is. Oh, the day really turned around. It was so, so rainy earlier. Now it's finally looking quite blue. The clouds look so pretty too. So nice out. There's a really nice breeze as well, which I am grateful for. Something I'm grateful for. I've been like meaning to think about things I'm grateful for more now, and the breeze is on the list for right now. Oh, so pretty. Every time I go for a walk, there's like a new wildflower or something that's popping up. It's actually kind of nice. Something to entertain myself with, basically. Like, let me show you this little situation here. Like, look at how pretty that looks. Especially with the lighting. The lighting is definitely making it look extra good. And then look at these ones here. Oh my gosh. This is choice cinematography right there. Let me do like a little zoom or pan or something. Spice things up a little.
that little flare in there as well. Okay, we're doing good. So pretty. You guys are coming on the walk with me. Look how pretty it is. It's a good time to go for a walk because it's just like the sun is like just setting, or not setting, but you know what I mean? Like it's kind of lower down. Everything looks so pretty. There's like a cooler temperature. There's a breeze. So good. Thankfully, there's not that many people out now for some reason. I would think there would be more. This morning, there were like a ton of cars going by. And now it's quiet, which is good. Because there's really not a sidewalk here. So I'm kind of enjoying the fact that there's not a lot of cars. I mean, there's definitely like a place for me to scoot on over if I needed to. There's definitely like extra room here to walk, but you know, it's not as, I don't really want to walk on the grass if I can avoid it. Especially because my sneakers are white. Good choice, Yana. Okay, we are back. We are sweaty. We are humid. We are just like, whoa. Oh. But yeah, I hope you're having a good day. I hope you are enjoying today, wherever you are, whenever you are watching this. I am giving you a big hug as per usual, sending you lots and lots of love, and I hope that you guys can join me for the next video. Bye! Bye.
Look at my hair. It is frizz town. Major frizz town.